Hey everybody, welcome back to the G1000 simulator at SimTech. Today we're going to show you how to cross-check and verify the points on a GPS approach procedure against a Jeppesen approach plate. We have the approach procedure loaded up here in the G1000, and you can check out videos on how to accomplish that and how to do at a proper approach briefing on our website. Check out the blog there at aviator.nyc. That said, for my cross-check here, I'm gonna come over onto the MFD and push flight plan to bring that up, and using the FMS cursor knob, push and turn the large button to scroll the cursor down to the point on our flight plan where our approach procedure is, and I'll get the whole thing showing there. So the first thing I'm going to look at is the procedure title, which I've got Farmingdale, New York, RNAV GPS runway 19. I covered up that a bit with my markup there, but there you go. And that agrees on the MFD here. Moving down from there, I will start with a bit of a disclaimer. The headings on GPS systems are rarely identical to what's on the approach plate charts. That is normal. They're within a couple of degrees. I'll consider them as the same. Starting at the top off of the initial approach fix where we're coming from, Blintz, that's on there. The heading on there showing us coming from the airport back to Blintz, so that's why we have a north-northeast bound heading. So I'll disregard that. 2,000 feet is the minimum altitude at Blintz, and the leg between Blintz and Derby. Next, as I said, we're going to Derby, which is going to be a 102 heading and 2,000 feet, once again, we just said. And then from Blintz to Maury is the next point, which is our final approach fix, and that is also our glide slope intercept altitude there at 1500. We'll check the glide there before we follow it down, and then we continue on to our missed approach point of runway 19, where we would execute the missed approach procedure, which is going to be a straight out climb runway heading 192 to 2,000 feet. And then we're going to make a left turn to 3,000 direct Deer Park and hold there over Deer Park, which is a 200 inbound heading and 4 mile legs. And I've got a 199 inbound heading and 4 mile legs, which all checks. I'll go on to look at the notes section here while I'm looking at the FMS against the approach plate and just make sure that there's nothing we missed. One, use the local altimeter setting. We'll have that today. If we didn't have it, we'd use the islip altimeter setting. And Barrow VNAV, not authorized. We don't have Barrow VNAV. That doesn't apply to us. Once again, there's another note 3 about Barrow VNAV, and note 4, helicopter, we're not a helicopter. Note 5 is somewhat important, the VASI and the RNAV glide path that we're going to be following on the LPV don't coincide, or they're not coincident. So we may be slightly off the VASI when we pop out of the clouds if we are right on the glide. And then if the tower were closed, the pilot controlled lighting is on the CTAF frequency of 118.8. Not always the case at all airports. Some airports have different frequencies for lighting, so that's important. And so we're looking in good shape on this approach between the plate and what's in the FMS. There are occasionally, not frequently, but it's not unheard of to have discrepancies between the chart and the GPS database. So we want to discover that in a low workload phase of flight. Currently, we're en route and about 40 minutes from destination, so we'd have time to find an alternate course of action if that were the case. And if This is a GPS approach, so it's especially important to discover those discrepancies early because the GPS is our only mode of navigation on this approach. If we were flying a conventional procedure, an ILS or VOR approach, I would also load the approach procedure in the G1000 and use that for situational awareness, but I would also go through and check the points just to make sure there's no discrepancies, errors. That would be a confusion to situational awareness at a high workload phase of flight. We hope you learned something from this video. If you did, please like and subscribe and check out our other videos on the blog at aviator.nyc and our YouTube channel.